So.
Hey guys, Pasty Boy here. Welcome back to Trailer Mods Phase 4. Today's project is going to be installing a collapsible shelf in the trailer. So let's get started. First little hack, bought some foam tape that I'm going to be putting on the aluminum posts to keep, you know, anything that's pressed up against it from vibrating and scraping and stuff like that. But before I do that with the bench here, I put a little piece on top and that'll help get it in the perfect position so I can put the knob back in place with the wood and the metal plate quicker. I know if I've got it there, boom, it's lined up. So I'm gonna put a little foam behind there. We'll get to that eventually, but first we're gonna remove the bench and use that as a little platform to set up the stuff we're gonna be working with today. This is the 1-inch wide, 1/8-inch thick foam that I bought. I'll put a link to this in the description below and everything else that we use today that can be purchased online. I'm gonna put the foam on the wall real quick. Now we've got the foam tape on the two uprights here, here and here. If need be, I'll put another piece over there. But for now, we're gonna leave it like that. There's the double outlet electrical plug that I installed a couple weeks ago. If you haven't seen that video, go check it out. Put a card up there at the top of the screen. Today I'll be using various tools and hardware. Briefly go over it here. You know, square, speed square, whatever, combination square. I got my digital caliper just to measure things that need to be measured accurately. Drill, tape measure, some hardware, knife, pencil, drill bits, that kind of stuff. I may need something else as we go a little further into it. But these are, if you can see in there, they're like screw headed, 1/4-20. So 1/4-20 by 1-inch machine screws. And then in this container, I've got 1/4-20 nuts with washers and lock washers. So that's pretty much what we're going to be using today, along with the stars of the show, the generic Harbor Freight riv nutter, riv nut tool with the 1/4-inch riv nuts. And then these are the 1/4-inch by 3/4, well, 1/4-20, 7/16 wrench size head, and they're 3/4 inches long to go into the riv nuts to bolt on these awesome collapsible stainless steel brackets, shelf brackets. So basically this is the upright position. Let me put this camera on the tripod and I'll show you how they work. Hopefully it's not too dark in here, but essentially this is the bracket. This will be mounted flush to one of those wall posts, one by one, and the shelf will be attached here. And then when you want to lower it, just push the button and it'll collapse down. You want to raise it, push the button again, which probably shouldn't be an issue because the actual shelf will be touching this, so it'll be ready to come right back up. Now you might be thinking, once that's mounted to the wall, it's gonna be bouncing around while you're driving down the road if it's gonna continuously unlock it. But I have a solution for that, which I will show you now. What I plan to do is, you've seen snaps like this, you may have some on your helmet or whatever. It's a pretty common thing. They come in three pieces because this portion would be affixed to whatever that is stationary, and then this portion here and one of these here go together in between some fabric like so. And then you use this little tool and this little base, oops, just drop that, and you kind of smush that end, or so that it acts like a rivet and it'll hold on. And so I couldn't find any, you know, strap material per se that was made for this purpose, so I'll show you what I got that's gonna work perfect. So I bought this 15 foot by 1 inch ratchet tie down. It's a Husky from Home Depot. It was less than $2, and it is going to serve as my material to attach to these snaps. Now you know how strong tie downs are, so I'm just gonna cut a little length, put one snap on the tie down, and screw it into the bottom side of the shelf. And then I will put the other piece of the snap, which would be this, and it actually already has a screw attached. Hopefully that will be strong enough to attach to the upright post here, framework, one by one aluminum post on the trailer side, and it'll be the right length that it'll just snap in and keep the shelf in place fairly securely while in transport. And this is the actual shelf that I'm going to be using. I did not have the ability to fabricate a shelf out of aluminum or steel or whatever, and it would have got quite costly. So I went with this 3/4 inch cabinet grade finished birch plywood. And I think what I'm going to do when I'm done is maybe give it a spray with Flex Seal to protect it, and it may actually, you know, keep it from too much moisture getting to it and stuff. But we'll see. I'm not going to do that part today, but we'll do everything else and get this mounted on the wall. Let's get started. So I've got one marked here, one marked there. It is, if you see, so one and two, that far in from the end of the trailer. That will be where I center the shelf. I've got a mark up here, 36 inches high off the floor. Same with the other side. And I marked it down 3/4 to compensate for the thickness of the plywood. So the bracket will go from here down. And it is the shorter leg goes against the wall. And I'm going to drill. You see I've already got it marked on both of these where the holes go, and they are center punched already. So I'm going to drill those and then install the riv nuts. All right, as you can see here, I've already got one of the holes drilled at 3/8. That works perfect to fit the riv nut in there. I'm going to pilot hole drill the other two with a 3/16 bit to start. It's kind of crucial to get these in the right position because these riv nuts are a fixed position, and so are the holes in the brackets, which I had to open up. They weren't big enough to fit a 1/4-20, so I had to put them on the drill press and open those up. But we will continue here. And so what I should probably do is put the one in and make sure that these line up. So let's put the one riv nut in before we drill anything else. Got the riv nut tool here and the 1/4-20. These are aluminum riv nuts, and I'm going to be putting steel bolts in, but should be okay. Should be using stainless steel, to be honest, but we got to work with what we've got. So screw that in there and put it in this hole and clamp it in. Let me bring you in close. In a bit. Yeah, that feels pretty tight. Should be good there. Just unscrew it. Alright. One down, three to go. Got an extension here on my impact, the 3/8 impact here. And got the 7/16 nut driver on it, and then got the bolt that we're going to be putting in this hole. So I'm just going to temporarily mount the bracket just to make sure that my alignment of the riv nuts is good, and I may drill the bottom one in while the bracket is attached. I don't have any of the lock washers or anything on there. I'm just going to put a lock washer on there. But I just want to make sure that that bottom one's lined up. And as I can see, it's a little off. So I'm going to drill that in place. That's going to make it hard to mount when, you know, you have the riv nut locked in. Then I'd have to oversize all these holes. So we're going to go just a little lower. And now I'll step it up. Step it up to the 3/8 drill bit. Get our riv nut ready. Haven't exactly figured out where to set this yet, for, you know, optimal crimping, so just kind of figuring it out as I go. Give it a crimp, and I can see it's still a little loose. There we go. I got a little bit more out of it there, and it's tight. Now that center one is going to be a little tricky, because I don't know if I can get the drill bit in there perfectly. All right, I've got the center hole drilled, and we'll get this last riv nut in place. All right, I have three bolts. They're 3/4 inch in length, 7/16 nut size, and it's a 1/4-20 thread to match the riv nuts. And I have the lock washer on there to prevent it from loosening up from vibration. If I do notice while traveling down the road, get to a destination and they are not holding up, I will put some Loctite on them. But for now, I'm going to try to get by with just a lock washer. So I'm going to do that for all three, and we're going to install this first bracket. Okay, so I've got the bolt through there. We'll line that up, and we'll just go a little easy. We're not going to crank it down just yet, because we want to make sure we get the other three lined up. And we'll put the second one on the bottom. And I got the third one here in my pocket. Alright, we'll tighten that middle one down. Yep. Bottom one, and now the bracket is a slightly wiggly, but once we attach the top to it, we shouldn't have any issues. So I'm just gonna good to go. The bracket itself is very snug and firm. Get a little close up. So there's one. Now, I thought typically the bracket would have the long side on the wall to create additional strength, but these show in the illustration this way. And you can see when you collapse it, it'll go down like that, and then up like that. So let's get the second one installed, and then we can start installing the shelf. Got the three riv nuts installed for the second bracket. And just to speed things up, I have two of these drills. One I had the 3/8 bit on, and the other the 3/16 bit, so I could try to drill the pilot hole and then the final hole in succession. And then my impact with the 7/16 nut driver on it, so that I could put the bracket in place temporarily and remove it quickly. And now, let's get that second bracket installed. Okay. right, now we have to figure out the layout of the shelf itself. So I'm gonna grab that and throw that on top. There's that. I think I'm gonna pull it away slightly from the framework since the brackets are a little bit, I should have went 13 and a half or 14 on this, but whatever. So I took and measured from the ends in, and it's 6 inches from each end in to the center of each bracket. So I'm just gonna make a pencil mark here and pencil mark here. And yeah, I'm gonna draw a line straight across. Yeah, actually I'm just gonna lay it down and I'm gonna mark these three holes on each bracket with a Sharpie. Like I said, I'm gonna pull it forward, so I need some type of spacer back there. So I think I'm gonna get my other framer pencil and use that as the spacer. Everyone has two carpenter's pencils, right? All right. Put it in vertically, I suppose. And push it back up. All right, I'm just gonna drill them out with a quarter inch drill bit, and if the hardware that I bought goes through, I'm gonna mount that up just like that. This is the hardware I decided to go with to bolt the wood down to the brackets. They're 1/4-20 thread, 1 inch long, and they have a Phillips and a flathead screw slot on them. So we're gonna be using 6 of these, 3 on each side. Probably could get away with 2 on each bracket, but I'm gonna do 3 and we'll get them cranked down nice. So let me go get a big flathead screwdriver and we're gonna start drilling the holes right now. Since this is just plywood, I'm gonna drill right on the brackets here, because as long as I don't hit the bracket, we should be just fine. Start with the front one. Now I'm just gonna check to see if the bolt passes through, and it does. So that's perfect. All right, let's drill them all. Now I'm gonna start with the one in the back. It's gonna be flipped up. We'll start with the one in the back since that is gonna be the least one to have any wiggle to it. I probably should have made sure these were square before I drilled. Let's check that while we're at it. Not so much. Well, let's bolt it up and see if it works anyway. Because if they're not square, they're not gonna hinge properly. I may have to re-drill. Didn't think of that. All right, so I marked this wall. And what I did was routed it all the way around with a 1/4 round. And go get my countersink. So I found some smaller washers that will work, and I'm going to change it up to nylon locking nuts instead, so I don't even need the lock washers. All right, moment of truth. Let's see if it closes, and I'm not, you know, faking this at all. But, all right, it's getting a little hung up. because I didn't line them up properly. All right, back to the drawing board. Let's get that straightened out. So that's fully lined up. She's not exactly pretty. I had to drill a couple holes for alignment. I guess I should have got these lined up better. This side was just fine. I didn't have to do anything. But the left side, this far outside hole here, was off quite a bit, about a quarter inch or so. So I had to re-drill that. Might get a replacement piece of wood, but now it actually closes, so push the releases and it sits flat against the trailer. Simple as that. I use the shelf, bam, there you go. That's it. You know, I got those straps that I want to use with the snaps, but I'm wondering if there's another way, simpler way. So I mean, if you're driving down the road, it's definitely gonna bounce around. But that does open and close nicely now. I like it. That's 36 inches off the ground, and that's a good height. That's countertop. That's countertop height. At home, I went in, measured the cabinet in the kitchen. I figured, well, if that's good enough for a work surface in the kitchen, it's probably a decent work surface in the trailer. Just came up with an alternative way to keep the bench secure. I just drilled a small hole in each rail, and I used those rubber straps that I bought a few weeks ago with the intent of using them to keep the bench in place, which is right here full of tools at the moment, but instead work out real well to keep that in place. Pretty taut but flexible, so I can damage the bench, and let's remove them and use the bench. All right, I figure it'd be easier to remove the ones on the bottom, because then you could just leave the straps dangling when you're using the bench. So let's see how this works. Back there. There you go. When I mentioned this idea to Gary, he said, what do you need a shelf for? I'm like, well, get done riding and you gotta take your clothes off and all that. You gotta put your helmet down somewhere, or I'm getting ready. I got all my camera gear. I can set all my camera gear down here. A GoPro with the case with all the GoPro stuff in it. The other handheld camera, whatever. The communicator. I got all kinds of stuff. And I just figured I could even put a second shelf maybe on the other side. But for now, one shelf, and I put it on the far side from where I have the bench, because I figured, you know, we'll keep the bench by itself for now. We got our shelf over here. So drop it down. Strap it in. But like I said, I think I'm going to treat it with Flex Seal so that it'll be a little more water resistant. I mean, granted, it's really just going to be the moisture in the air that's going to get to it. We're not going to be putting so much wet stuff on it, but at the same time, it will be protected from the year-round moisture. Even in the summer, it's going to be really moist. And it's tucked away. That's not going anywhere. All right, so let's recap what we've done so far. So let's start with phase one.
Phase one, we put a triple hook here, double hook there, and that was actually, I think, phase three. triple hook here, double hook there, triple hook there. The broom was also part of the hook phase. Almost forgot to mention that. Broom is very important in a hybrid trailer because you're going to get a lot of snow in here that won't fall out when because you're not tilting it. So don't forget the broom. Then phase two was the bench mount with the screw down. Phase three was the electrical outlet right there. And then phase four is today with a bench top shelf, collapsible shelf with the straps that hold it in place. I'm not saying I won't do any more, but I think I've done quite enough. I've also got, as you guys have seen, I didn't do a video on it because it, you know, I've already been using them and everything, but I got the super clamps instead of using the Triton tie downs that come with. The super clamps are awesome. If you guys want me to make a video of that, leave a comment below and I'll just show you how they work. But they just make loading and unloading super fast and convenient. So there are all of the mods up to this point, phase four. All right, guys, I want to thank you for watching. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you're interested in any of the items I used for this build, check the link in the description. Check out my Amazon affiliate page. Also, go like me, Pasty Boy, on Facebook and Instagram. Click that bell for notifications. Check out another video that is suggested at the end of this one. And we'll see you next time. Thanks for watching. Take care.